Newly born mom.
I'm a newly born mom.
And daddy.
Daddy. The juicy comments that everyone always asks.
Strutting out that baby. Thought you were hot as ever.
Hemorrhoids.
I went to Subway every day.
Did you poop?
Blood.
No. Nobody talks about it.
My eyes are watering.
Oh.
You're cute when you do it.
Thanks.
Hey.
Hey guys, welcome back to our channel.
We definitely haven't done like a sitting down one in a while. Let's do this. That's what Ozzy says.
Let's do this. She says that to everything. Welcome back to our channel. I just asked my Instagram a pregnancy Q&A / birth Q&A. So I piled together the best questions and we'll be answering those. They're pretty juicy. Let's get right into it. Don't forget to hit subscribe, like, and comment on this video if you think it's fun. Question number one. Was this pregnancy harder than the last pregnancy? I would say it was easier than the last pregnancy.
It felt significantly easier.
Yeah, for both of us.
Yeah, because I had to go through a lot.
Tanner went through a lot.
No, but watching you, I was like, whoa, this is a breeze for you.
Yeah, it's obviously not like the easiest thing ever, but I felt very, I don't know if it's because I already went through it, probably.
Probably.
But I knew kind of what to expect, and then I didn't let it make me sad that like my body was changing or like I felt more tired. Right. I would just be like, yeah, I'm pregnant, like this is great.
Whatever.
I still kept my normal routine, which I think really, really helped me mentally. I went to CrossFit every day. Literally the morning that I gave birth, I was at CrossFit. Yeah, I think this one was easier. If you do get pregnant, I would recommend, you know, soaking it up because it's pretty cool that you get to do that. Number two, were you scared to go through labor again, knowing how it was for you the first time? So this is kind of crazy because when I gave birth to Ozzy, I think I told you I'm never doing that again. I knew I wanted more kids, but I was like, there's no way, I can't.
But it didn't seem like that was even like ever gonna happen. Like, we both knew like, yeah, we want more kids, but I was like,
I was like, this was so hard, I'm never doing it again. Yeah. And so like, I thought when I got pregnant with Stella, I was like, oh my gosh, like I wondered if I was gonna be like super scared for birth because of that. But I was actually so excited to give birth to Stella, and I was excited to like have it go in a positive way, which it did, which I was so grateful for. And then the next question is, biggest difference between Ozzy and Stella's birth and pregnancies? So that kind of goes into it. I feel like their births were so different because going into Ozzy's birth, I was so excited, but then I got filled with like anxiety and I was so scared through it because her heart rate kept dropping because the cord was wrapped around her neck. And my nurse, she wasn't like confident and like not
with
making,
Ozzy.
Yeah, with Ozzy, she like wasn't making me feel like everything was gonna be okay. So I think that one was just filled with stress. And so I think the biggest difference would be like, I was so confident going into Stella's birth and I was just like prepared for anything. And there was no like worry about how she was doing. I had like the best nurses ever. My doctor was amazing. I just feel like it was just night and day. So I was able to enjoy the whole experience. Like I actually had a lot of fun. Like I was like in the hospital and I was like, oh, I can do this again.
I gotta get her.
Okay.
Dad.
That's Ozzy.
We're back. And Daddy.
Even though I had kind of like a scary experience with Ozzy, I still was able to be like super excited. Right after I gave birth, I told Tanner like, I can do this again. Like that was actually fun.
Yeah, so different.
Okay, what was it like holding her in your arms for the first time? So you can go first.
What was it like? Like, just like I was melting. We got a clip of it, which I was grateful for, our videographer. It's in our video, but and I grabbed it from Lauren, and I was talking to Lauren about this like before, like while she was pregnant, and I was just like, I almost wanted a boy next because I wasn't sure if I would like have that same special daddy-daughter, like she's my girl type thing, like I do with Oz. So like when I grabbed it for the first time, I had that thought like, oh man, I hope I like her. I hope I feel that. And I just like, yeah, I held her and then I looked into her little eyes and I just like was overwhelmed with so much love, and it was like, yeah, like what they say, like you just make more room in your heart and you don't love one more than the other. It was like I was overwhelmed and just started crying.
And then for me, it was like, because I'm like pushing, right, with all my might. And then I'm like, I've grown this baby for 10 months now. I've done all the work to get her here safely. There's something so crazy about her being like brought to my chest, and you're just like, oh my gosh, like she's here. I think the word is just like overwhelmed of like love and just grateful that she's here safely and that she's healthy, and just like all that hard work is like paying off, and you're just like, oh my gosh, like you can take in that she's actually here. And it's so crazy going from, oh, I'm pregnant, like da 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 da, you have a pregnant belly, to like, actually, that's a baby that was growing inside you, and here she is, like right here. So it's such a crazy, crazy feeling. I feel like it's like spiritual and just really, really cool.
Yeah.
I don't know how else to describe it.
Rush in, like it's fast.
It's so fast. And then
your body's like rushed, filled up.
Like once again, she's not a part of your life, and then all of a sudden it's like, how were you not a part of your life?
Like I remember with Ozzy, I described it as like, oh my gosh, it feels like all the blood is like rushing through my body again.
Next question. Did you have morning sickness in your pregnancy? I don't think I did. I'm very grateful. My pregnancy seems like, looking back at it, seemed so easy. I don't have anything that stands out that was so hard, which obviously you're growing a human and things are like harder than normal, but I'm just really grateful that I had a fairly easy pregnancy. I think I threw up like 3 times total.
Yeah.
It was in the middle of the night, and it was after I would eat not good that day.
Yeah.
Like if I had two meals eating out, then those were my 3 times that I barked.
Yeah. Fried food.
Yeah, fried food. And my heartburn, that was the worst part, was heartburn in the last part of my pregnancy. I had to have Tums a lot in the middle of the night. I would say that was the worst part. Next cue, what was my craving?
I went to Subway every day for 10 months.
Almost every day.
Oh yeah, you're right. They're closed on Sunday.
Oh my gosh.
The lady that worked there had the sub memorized.
I finally went in to order it on my own. I sound terrible if I say that, but Tanner loves to go to the store.
Yeah, I need to get out of the house.
He likes to get out of the house to go get like drinks or whatever. So he was the one getting my Subway. And then I went in and I started ordering my sandwich, and she goes, so do you have a husband that comes in here that's blonde? And I started laughing. I was like, yeah, I do. And she goes, okay, I thought I recognized the Subway sandwich.
We'll have to drop the sandwich.
Yeah, I'll drop the sandwich. I actually got a request for like people saying like, what do you order?
That's funny, because like Tony Hawk did like a TikTok where he made his like Tony Hawk sub, the Logeason sub.
What is something that you wish you knew about pregnancy that isn't talked about much? The heartburn is bad. I think it would just be like after. I wish that postpartum was more talked about, because that's the hardest part for me, is actually recovering with a newborn, with a baby, and a toddler. Yeah. So, do you have anything?
Like from the dad's
lost
side.
In thought?
I don't know if there's something that I wish was more talked about, but something that was like unexpected, I guess, is just with 2 kids now, it feels like I don't really get to spend a ton of time with Stella, because I gotta make sure that Ozzy isn't setting our house on fire.
And also that she's like not feeling neglected.
But then sometimes I'm like, man, I'm like missing this time. Like I had all that time with Ozzy to like hold her and create. She was the only one when she was just tiny. And I don't really get that as much with Stella. So that's something that I'm like.
Yeah, cause I can't lift Ozzy up, and I can't go in the water yet and all those things. And so I'm not able to really like do that stuff with Ozzy. So yeah. Tanner's really taken on the role of like being with Ozzy a lot.
Which I love, but it does feel like, I guess like there was like one thing I didn't anticipate was like, dang, like,
yeah.
She's growing up. I almost cried thinking about
that. You're not missing her.
Eyes are watering.
Oh, I feel the same way about Ozzy though.
Yeah, it's like vice versa. Okay. It'll all even out.
Ozzy.
Yeah.
These are the juicy comments that everyone always asks. Did you tear? I did indeed tear, everyone. No, it wasn't that bad though.
I watched them stitch it up.
Oh my gosh. I can feel that.
The doctor's just like, the way they do it is just so nonchalant. They're just like, oh yeah, your baby looks great. Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh.
Blood.
I got that epidural, dilated to a 6. I got the epidural.
Where was I going with that? I don't know, the question is, did you tear?
Oh yeah. I'm a newborn mom with a toddler.
I'm a newborn mom. I'm a newly born mom.
I'm a newly born mom. I have a newborn and a little mama. And boop.
And boop. Boop. Come here, boop, boop.
Boop, boop. Boop.
Come boop me.
Go boop daddy.
Ooh, boop.
So what I was going with that is I got that Epidural at 6. It numbed me in my lower stomach, but I could still feel the contractions, the pressure of the contractions, very much so. And I also could feel the pressure when I was pushing. I could feel a lot of when I was pushing her out. So I think that was a motivation to getting her out very quickly because my labor of pushing her was only 15 minutes long. So I was like, get her out of here. I pushed like 4 times, I think.
So fast.
So it's crazy because like with Ozzy, I remember like her head got to where it's called crowning and then I had to wait for contraction and push the rest of her head out. But with Stella, it was all at once. Like I pushed her head out and her whole body out in the same push.
Like a little blob.
It was crazy because I could feel myself about to tear, but I like didn't care because I just like wanted her out so bad. But it was a first degree tear. It wasn't bad. And honestly, do you want to know what's worse that people don't talk about? Hemorrhoids. And I did get a little one, and that is worse than the stitches from tearing.
You talking about the hemis?
Yeah. Ooh. I've got to say, that's worse. But honestly, this one was way
better. I would
say
that that's something that's like, I've never heard of.
Yeah, I've never heard of that. I didn't think that was going to be a thing.
And it was the worst part.
That was the worst. With Ozzy, I couldn't even stand up. After giving birth, they were like, okay, like we need to have you go to the bathroom. And I'm like, I honestly can't stand up because it feels like my butt is outside of my butt. That might be TMI, but.
That's what we're here for.
Nobody talks about it. I don't know, expect the unexpected, I guess.
Hemis.
But with this one, I only got a very small hemorrhoid, so it wasn't as bad. And yeah. So I'm very grateful that my recovery has been a lot better. I would say that CrossFit has helped me. People have asked if working out through my pregnancy helped with labor and delivery. I would say 100%, not only mentally, but physically probably. And just gave me the strength and endurance to do everything that I needed to do.
It's a physical task.
Physical task it is to give birth. The next question was, how long did you push? And I pushed for 15 minutes. So she was quickly out. Okay, how is breastfeeding with baby number 2? This is another thing that isn't talked about too much. Breastfeeding is hard. It was just as bad breastfeeding Stella as it was with Ozzy. So it's not like your boobs like get used to it and then it's like easy with your next baby. It's just as hard. I say that it's 2 weeks of hell. And then after that, it becomes much better. Both of my babies had a tongue tie, and so they kind of wrecked my boobs in the first 24 hours of eating, just because their latch isn't as good, and then they just kind of rub you raw. So I got blisters with both of them in like the first day of feeding them. Then it just takes a long time to recover because you obviously have to keep feeding them, and it's just like, That is like seriously what causes me the most pain, because you're breastfeeding. And something else that they don't talk about, you start contracting. So you have contractions while you're breastfeeding because that's how your uterus contracts back down. So you're having these terrible contractions. Your nipples feel like so bad and it's just like all happening at once. So like that's what brings me the most sadness. I'll start crying or break down in those first 2 weeks for sure, just because of the nipple pain and feeling the contraction at the same time. And you're just like, oh my gosh, I can't do it. It hurts so bad. It's so bad. Some people don't even feel pain, and I don't understand that. No, some people say that they never feel pain breastfeeding, so to that, I don't know how to do that. Don't ask me. This is a question I'm gonna ask Tanner. How did you guys cope with attraction during your pregnancy with body changes? How did you stay attracted to me while I was going through body changes?
Okay.
I think that's the question, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thanks for asking the question, but I think that the question is kind of, I don't know, it's assuming that I'm not attracted to you as you're growing a baby. Because like coping, like, oh, I got to cope with this thing that's so hard because I'm not attracted to you.
But I think a lot of people are scared about like, oh, my husband's not going to think I'm attracted.
You watch your wife go through this like incredible transformation and you know that she's creating a human inside of her stomach.
Did you think I was attractive throughout? Did you ever think I was not attractive?
No.
That's never.
Even when you're just grunting out that baby, you thought you were hot as ever.
Sweet. And neither did I. I didn't lose attraction of myself. I was like, oh. I don't know where I was going with that. Okay, how bad does pushing actually hurt? I would say pushing is the least painful part.
So why do you scream? Because that's what I would want
to
ask.
The contractions are the worst part for me. And feeling like you need to push is worse than actually pushing. It feels so much better when you actually get to push because your body is like urging you. You have to push, and it feels so much better when you do push.
Because you're like fighting it up until the point where they're like, okay, you're ready, you can push now.
Yes. I think pushing is hard, it's tiring, it's very tiring. It's not as painful, I would say, as leading up to pushing. People maybe disagree with me on this if they don't get the epidural, because I get the epidural, it's probably different for them. But if you do get the epidural, I would say pushing is definitely more satisfying. So I think the screaming comes from pushing with everything that you have, the noises that come from it or whatever.
So it's not necessarily a pain scream.
It's not the pain scream. It's you're doing it with everything that you've got. Like, it's tiring. These last questions, I think, are the best.
Oh, cool. Yeah, let's do it.
Did you poop? Is a common question that I've been asked.
Do you poop? Like, do girls poop? And no, they don't.
They still don't. No, thankfully. So my nurse made sure that I felt comfortable and was like, don't worry, it's really normal if you do. You won't even know that it happened, da da da. But then after I gave birth, she was like, hey, you didn't even poop. And I was like, sweet. I think my other nurse told me I didn't poop with Ozzy as well. But if you do, it's super normal.
This is the tool.
Don't feel bad if that happens. How has the transition been from babies 1 to 2? I think it's a lot easier going from 1 to 2 than 0 to 1. Because...
In some ways.
In some ways it's easier because your life is already changed to kids. Like, yeah. You've now had...
You're in like a kid mindset.
You're in a kid mindset. You're not like... It's not as like selfishly about just you anymore. It's already been about your child. So it's easier in that way, but hard in a way of... There's two of them, so it's like one of us has to be with a baby at all times. Unless they're both sleeping, which is really nice.
It hardly happens.
It happens for like 30 minutes. No, but it's been really good though. Okay. Best advice for husbands in preparation for pregnancy and labor.
In preparation for pregnancy and labor.
Yes.
I have some advice for you, gentlemen. One main thing is to, like I talked about earlier, like your wife's doing this crazy, incredible, like insane thing of creating a human, and we don't understand. And we never will understand. You have no idea. So they're doing this crazy hard thing, and there's a lot of hormones going on. One of my biggest things that I'm always working on is just like patience and seeking to understand before being understood kind of principle. Just like understand, like if for whatever reason they're not in the greatest mood and you're like, why are you upset? And you're like, oh yeah, I forgot you're doing this crazy thing. And that's not to say that like, Laura, I'm just upset the whole time, but that was one thing that I always had to remind myself, and it's just the fact that like that's hard, their body's going through all these changes, and you just have to be there to be supportive and like understand that you don't understand. That's one thing. Getting ready for labor, just like once again, you're there to support, and it's like the sickest thing ever. And unless you're like super super queasy with blood and stuff, I think that you should watch the whole thing because it's the coolest thing I've ever seen. I'm just like
so blown
away. My adrenaline is up, like firing, and I'm just like, what? It happened again?
Like, it's like, did I miss it?
Did I blink? How did you shove that thing out of you? I'm like, yeah, watch, like help, do what you can, do what the nurses ask you to do, and it's such a cool experience. So patience and support. I wasn't trying to make you look bad there.
Yeah,
did I say that right?
Was I like a witch?
No, I mean, it's just like stuff happens when you're pregnant. You're just like, you're in pain, you're uncomfortable. And
sometimes I'm gonna be in a bad mood.
That's what I'm saying. I'm not trying to make her look crazy. I'm just saying for the men, you really just have to remind yourself often of what they're doing, because it's easy to forget. Like, especially this time when you're just like acting so normal, so normal, so normal.
Yeah.
And then you like have a tough day and I'm like, why is she having a tough day? Like, she's superwoman. Oh, I forgot. That's actually a hard thing she's doing.
Yeah, that's a better way to say this question. I'm curious about being intimate after birth. Does it hurt? How long do you have to wait?
We'll tell you when it happens.
Yeah, so we're...
We'll get there when we get there.
We'll get there when we get there. I don't even want to think about that right now. Okay, so I'm 3 weeks postpartum right now. You're supposed to wait 6 weeks postpartum.
You have to get cleared by
the
doctor.
It's like you have like a checkup with your doctor. They clear you. With Ozzy, I can speak to hers.
Oh,
I would say it was similar to having sex for the first time.
Like ever in your life.
Ever in your life. Yeah. Like it just feels, I don't know how, but it feels like tight again. And it's just like
painful.
It's more painful. So just my advice would be to go slow, just like it's your first time, and make sure your husband remembers to go slow. That's the only, I think that's the best advice I could give.
Yeah.
And
which is like super easy to do after 6 weeks.
Yeah. Chomping at the bit. No, this is like the worst. I would say it's uncomfortable.
Yes.
It's uncomfortable. It doesn't hurt.
Yeah.
As long as you go slow. Enough. Yeah, Tanner's like, yes. Yeah. It doesn't hurt. 6 weeks and it's not painful, just uncomfortable. But then it goes back to normal. It just takes a couple of times. I can't remember how long it took.
Couple.
I think it was like a month and then I felt normal again. Like I didn't have to like worry about it like being uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Last question, is Stella similar to Ozzy? I would say
it's hard to tell yet because like they're not really like blossoming.
But in the newborn stage that she's at right now, I would say that Ozzy is an incredible baby. At this point though, she hated her car seat. She would like scream like till she wouldn't breathe in her car seat, so we'd have to pull over constantly. And she also loved to eat often, so like sleeping at night was not happening until she was like 2 months old. It was 2 months old when she slept through the night for the first time. But until then, I feel like I was like a zombie because I never caught up on sleep. With Stella, she, like the first night she was born, she slept 4.5 hours, two different chunks, like in the night. And I was like, what is happening? I was prepared to like not sleep.
She's an amazing
sleeper. Ozzy was a good baby. Stella's even better, I would say.
Ouch.
No, I mean as a newborn. Ozzy's freaking amazing. I'm saying easier.
I would say differences. Stella sleeps more, spits up more.
Yes.
Ozzy didn't spit up once.
Never spit
maybe
up.
Actually once, and went to the hospital.
Yeah. And Stella spits up definitely at least once a day now.
Ozzy looked more like me. Stella is a Lauren replica.
But it's funny because everyone's saying that Stella looks like Ozzy. So there must be
I see the connection there, but if you just go from us, like Stella is you, Ozzy is me, but now Ozzy's morphing into you, so I lost now. Both. But Ozzy still does have my eyes. And
Ozzy
my
still looks like you.
Structure right here.
I would say she still looks like you. Anyway, we have the best babies. I'm so grateful.
Yes.
They're both angels, and I'm just grateful that she's here and she's safe, and it was such a good experience. And if you're pregnant, then I hope nothing but the best for you and your deliveries.
And we're stoked for you.
You've got this. Have fun. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like it. Subscribe to our channel so you don't miss another video. And we'll be back next week. We love you guys. Talk to you soon.
See ya.
Yeah.
No, like this. See ya.
See ya.
See ya later.
I love you.